tonight, just a little ways up the road there at 9 p.m., Lindsay Webster is going to be performing at Keegan Ales. If you haven't heard Lindsay Webster before, she's a native of the Hudson Valley, originally from Woodstock, studied performance in New York City, and has, over the last 5 or 6 years, begun performing nationally and internationally. She has a beautiful, dark, rich voice. It's perfect for the kind of R&B pop that they're doing. It's vaguely reminiscent of Syeda Garrett. You remember Syeda Garrett?
Yes, I do. Mm-hmm.
Her voice kind of reminds me of Syeda. So she'll be performing at Keegan Ales tonight at 9 o'clock. If you're in the area and you're into R&B and soul, I definitely recommend checking her out.
That sounds like a good place to be.
Also tonight, in Woodstock, the Paul Green Rock Academy. If you're not familiar with this, it's a school for children to learn to play musical instruments.
Yes, I haven't been there, but I have heard of it before, but I have not had the opportunity to get up that far. Well, transportation being an issue, I mean, from here to there, but yeah. Yes, I have heard of it.
Yeah, it's to teach children how to play instruments that are common to rock music, guitars, drums, keyboards. And they're doing the music of the Ramones this week.
The Ramones?
The Ramones, yes.
Oh, yeah.
So these kids do a great job.
Right.
Yeah. So they've been working in the Hudson Valley. They're based out of Saugerties. They've been working for 17 years. They've got a great staff of teachers there. They hold weekly lessons, summer workshops. And if you got two kids, you'll get a discount on the tuition for the project. For the program, I mean, not project program. And they're doing the music of the Ramones tonight at the Utopia Soundstage in Woodstock. Next week, on the 15th and the 16th, they'll be doing progressive rock. And to finish out the month on the 22nd and the 23rd, they're doing the music of Jesus Christ Superstar.
Now that was my stepdaughter's favorite movie. In fact, I wanted to send her some tickets to that all the way out in Texas. Believe it or not, when they did that on Broadway, they did the play on Broadway. I wanted to send her some tickets because I knew she would fly all the way back out to New York just to see that on Broadway. But she watched that from the age of like 3 right on up to 16. That was her favorite. And I was like, what do you really get the storyline out of this? Because it was a rock opera, you know, and that was it. She wanted to watch it every day. And she got to where she could sing the songs and everything. And she has a beautiful voice, but she's an artist. And it was amazing. But I've never seen anybody fall in love with one rock opera of any sort, you know, the way she did with that. But that was her favorite for many, many years. And she used to always bring it up to my apartment. Let's watch this. Let's watch. And I watched it over and over and over. And it was like, I ended up just going to sleep with these tunes in my head, you know. Jesus Christ Superstar, you know, and all getting off the bus in the middle of the desert. And the whole scene, you know. I was like, oh, God. but yeah, I did love the music. But yeah, even as we talk about it, the songs are rolling in my head. But yeah, that I would like to see that. I really would. But anyway, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt.
Oh, no.
Your report. Just flashback.
I see. It's music that touches everybody. That's the point. And that's, you know, these kids do a great job at the program. The teachers do a great job. It'll be a good night if you're in the area. Check it out at the Utopia Soundstage in Woodstock.
Right.
The Paul Green Rock Academy. Coming up at the end of this coming week, I talked about them a couple weeks ago. Jeff Lober and his band, You Guys, be performing at the China Rose in Rhinecliff. I had the opportunity to hear Jeff Lober perform at the Morton Library back in December. The Morton Library does a monthly acoustic singer-songwriter showcase. And he was like somewhere between James Taylor and Bruce Springsteen. And I really liked what he was doing, and I'm looking forward to hearing his music with a band accompanying him. So that'll be starting Friday night at the China Rose in Rhinecliff. And also, right before that, at 8 p.m., is the January show at the Morton Library.
Right.
And this month, they'll have performances from Michael Cole with Greg Douglas, R.V. Henninger, Gianna Carey, and Ethan Campbell.
Right.
I know Ethan Campbell. I've had the chance to play on the same bill as him a couple times. And he's very good. Original singer-songwriter, music, it's how to describe it, it's in the vein of kind of like Zeppelin's acoustic stuff.
Right.
You know, their kind of stuff. So Ethan's always a lot of fun, and Michael Cole and Greg Douglas are great together. I've heard them perform together many times. They have a great chemistry. They do originals and covers in like early 60s R&B kind of style. Yeah. A little bit of Motown, a little bit of soul to it. You know. And then they'll also go more recently to kind of like the mid-80s new wave pop
this
style.
This is the kind of entertainment I'd like to see come to Poughkeepsie. I mean, there's a lot of talent here in Poughkeepsie. But there, as far as having, you know, quality places to play, this is where new business needs to open up in Poughkeepsie, you know, to provide more places for live entertainment. You know, we have open mic nights and stuff like that. But to have, you know, the standard bands to come in and play on a regular basis, like Woodstock does, Red Hook, you know, and even Highland, you know, Beacon, and, you know, the surrounding areas. To have quality bands come in and play on a regular, consistent basis. We don't have these shops open. We don't have the places to play. We have a few, but not as many as we should, you know, to consider ourselves, you know, a real focal point as far as entertainment. But there is so much quality, entertainers in the area that we should. And that's hopefully what we're going to gravitate to. You know, working with a new city government and council and everything else. Hopefully that's what we're going to get. That's the reason I want to do this sponsorship drive. There's a lot of new places opening up. And that's the reason, one of the reasons I want to get involved in that.
I think it would be good for the area, too.
Yes.
But on that note, there's an opportunity. If you've been meaning to check out some of the musicians I talk about, haven't been able to make the trip, I'm excited to announce on February 13th, my friends Greg, Carl, and a percussion player I've seen them with a few times, Norman Del Tufer. I probably just butchered that last name, something awful. Norman Del Tufer. They'll be performing at Mahoney's.
Oh.
Okay. Starting at 7 p.m. on February 13th here in Poughkeepsie.
Right.
And Carl is a fantastic guitar player. They call him the Eric Clapton of the Hudson Valley.
Eric Clapton I've always been a fan of.
Yes.
Always.
Greg is a wonderful singer and a beautiful human being. I don't know Norman personally, but I've heard him play, and he's a great, very intuitive percussionist. Very, I don't know how to put it, is a tasteful, smart.
Right.
You know, percussion accompaniment. So I've heard them perform before. They played up in Rhinecliff several times around the holidays. I had the opportunity to hear them perform then. They'll be performing at Mahoney's in Poughkeepsie on February 13th at 7 p.m.
Awesome. And that is a nice place to be. It really is. Mahoney's is a nice place. I'm looking forward to going down there, and they are on my list of stopping by during the sponsorship drive. I keep bringing that up, but there's not too many places I'm not going to go to during the sponsorship drive, because I couldn't really call us the voice of the city of Poughkeepsie if I did not, you know, try to get everybody involved, because we're going to try to get everybody involved with the growth of the city of Poughkeepsie, and we're going to try to speak for everybody as far as bringing entertainment
you know, to the city and liven this place up just a little bit more.
Hopefully, stuff like this coming up at Mahoney's can be the beginning of something.
Right. Hopefully. If you ever do have the opportunity to bring any of these individuals on the show, please do give them an offer. You know?
I'm in talks with a few that I'm excited about bringing in. Don't have anything to announce just yet, but hopefully soon I will.
Okay. Yes. Excellent. Excellent. That would be great.
There's a couple more shows I wanted to mention. Let's see, where was I? A little farther up the road in Rosendale. I think I mentioned it last time. Tonight at 8 p.m., Laura Hope and the Arctones. Excellent rockabilly band. It's the last chance to catch them up here as they're about to head south. Rosendale Cafe, 8 p.m. tonight at 9 o'clock. This is an important mention. I want to mention this because of the charity.
Right.
Mm. Taste Buds Cafe up in Red Hook. Tuesday night, I'll be performing there along with Matthew Kabalkin, who's a very original singer-songwriter from the Upper Dutchess County area. We're starting at 7 o'clock at Taste Buds. Every month, Taste Buds does a charity.
Right.
It varies from one month to another, but this month, it's a cure for Maddie. Maddie is a 7-year-old who has juvenile dermatomyositis. It's too early in the morning for these big words.
I understand.
Dermatomyositis. Myositis. Dermatomyositis. It's an autoimmune disease.
Right.
The body's attacks its own skin.
Right.
All right. There's only two doctors who are doing research into this condition. It's rare. It's very painful. Right now there's no cure for it.
Oh, wow.
All right. And treatments for this, it's costing 5 figures a month.
Wow.
So we're trying to get some money for this family so they can help take care of Maddie. And if you want to get involved to help achieve a cure for this illness,
right.
curejm.org.
Please check that out, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
This is a very worthy cause. And if you get an opportunity to listen to Mr. James Burke, I really suggest you do. He is a very wonderful entertainer. And that I can vouch for. I've heard him on several occasions.
He is
very, very talented.
Yes, he is.
And in fact, you can see some of those on the open mic night and also on the broadcast here on the show. We've been very fortunate to have him play here in the studio. And he's a very talented performer. And I give him 2 thumbs up on his guitar playing and his vocals. And if you get an opportunity to see him, please do, and this is a very, very, very serious issue, and a very wonderful cause. So if you get a chance to go out, or please look this up on the, and this is on the web, right?
Yes, curejm.org. It's a juvenile dermatomyositis.
Right.
It's an autoimmune disease. There's no cure. There's only 2 doctors. Trying to research the condition because it's rare, there's no funding, and it affects lots of people, like Maddie,
right,
who's only 7 years old and has been afflicted with this for about 3.5 years now.
Wow, so that is truly sad. So ladies and gentlemen, if you can help Maddie out, please look this up, get involved, and check out a very great show. If you have any questions, you can call us here. Our number is 845-471-8180. You're listening to WHVW, 950 AM. And, wow, that really pulls on the heartstrings.
Mm-hmm.
Man. Wow, I ain't even got to my morning read, and that makes me want to take a shot of coffee right there.
Well, it's just one of the wonderful things, and it's why it would be so great to get a little more of this going on in Poughkeepsie.
Yes.
You know, music can help bring people together for causes like this.
Exactly, and these are the things we're trying to promote. We're trying to get people involved. It's all about community involvement, and these are the things that need to happen. You know, and you rally around these things, and people don't really understand just how much involvement does This is the reason I've been involved in so many volunteer organizations, you know, and it's like when I first seen, you know, like the waterfront, you know, advocacy committee that it was that I just got notified last week that they was going to try to form. I want to get involved in that, but it's going to take me a couple of days to put a resume together. Mm-hmm. Because after 22 years, it's hard to pull the paperwork together to get a resume before that. But it's helped so many people. Mm-hmm. But same way with these issues here, that's even greater than what I've ever done, because this benefits a child with a specific problem that can get passed by so easily just because it's one child, you know. And people don't understand that it's a life. Mm-hmm. That is a life, and it matters. Mm-hmm. Life matters. Even if it's one life, it matters. So, ladies and gentlemen, please get involved. Enjoy the entertainment. Enjoy your life and be blessed. You have a good life. So, on with the entertainment read.
I want to end on a lighter note, something a little happier. At BSP tonight in Kingston, the Black Horse Riders and Yard Sale, two bands starting at 9 p.m. BSP is always great for really unique, under the radar kind of talent. Always have good stuff in there. And for those of us who like dancing, in Marlboro at the Falcon on Tuesday, the Dodo Jance Company's Argentine Tango and Salsa starting at 6:30, tango lesson at 7:30, and a salsa lesson at 8:30. The whole thing runs till 10 o'clock.
Awesome.
Enjoy dancing, the Falcon, Tuesday. Yep.
Falcons are my friends on Facebook. I've actually seen that posted, but I normally don't read the stuff off my Facebook page. I usually read it what's posted on Happenings Around the Hudson. And by the way, speaking of Happenings Around the Hudson, we're going to be building a Happenings Around the Hudson Valley Facebook for itself. The page, the individual page, which is originated off of my Facebook, is like getting overcrowded. So we're going to build a Facebook for Happenings Around the Hudson Valley where it can handle the capacity which a page cannot handle. So as soon as we get Miss Kelsey Cox here, she's going to help us build a Facebook page, take off the Facebook page and invite everyone over to the Facebook itself. So you can post what events you have, and then we will read those off of that Facebook itself. So everything that you post on there in its entirety, we will read right off of the Facebook itself.
Hopefully so a little more efficient, so that nothing gets lost.
Exactly. We'll have someone help monitor that Facebook. We'll have someone else answer the questions, ask the questions that need to be asked, and we'll be able to keep up with it. So it'll be a lot easier to contact through Facebook. It'll be a lot easier for PTA members, people, fundraisers, and keep up with the city. It is extremely hard to do what we have to do with just one person, or asking me and my wife, which runs the house. Thank you very much, dear. You support me, but I can't ask you to do everything for me. But I'm glad you do. But it's overwhelming at times, so I definitely needed a volunteer, and the Lord has blessed me with a volunteer, and that's all thanks to Mr. Nicholas Dindulu and from Vassar College for sending me Miss Kelsey Cox, and we'll be looking forward to her being here. So until that takes place, we won't be working on other things, building up and promoting the businesses around here for the sponsorship drive. So with that being said, I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Derek Roberts and see what's happening around the Hudson Valley.
Hello, everybody, and have a good morning, and enjoy life as best we can. And I will say a special shout out to my brother Rodney, who came out of the hospital this week from prostate surgery. He's home with us. And he seems to be doing real well.
Glad to hear that.
Amen.
Yes. So I was going to say, there ain't that much around the Hudson Valley on Saturday. I've been checking the Newport Times. I will tell you about some of my adventures, which I ain't been doing much because I mean, like, to want to go out, but that wind chill factor the last couple of days, it really put a cramp in any walking skills, you know. So, basically, I think it was yesterday, I went up to Albany, or the day before, for the Fight for 15. I met some old friends of mine, like Joe Sapper of 1199, Blair Goodman, and we had the lovely and always popular Pam Krinsky there too to support the people trying to get the wages up to 15 because people cannot survive on what we're making now. I mean, it's impossible. You got a family, you got medical bills, school loans, whatever. 15 is just a start. It's not the solution, but it's a start. And we went up there and trying, you know, try to push it faster because by the time they're saying they're going to give us the wage 15 in 2020, you have to go up to $20 to $25 an hour to survive. And it's just not, you know, we need it now, not later. And after we do this session with the three of us today, I have to do something. It's maybe because they're political, but what I'm going to be doing is pushing for Bernie Sanders because I met a new Facebook friend named Marie Quackenbush, and she's running District 19 to get the vote out for Bernie because I think that is very important. And I'll be busy for that for the rest of the week. And then next week I'll be going to Albany a lot, so for different events. And like I said, I'm also going to talk to my Unitarian Fellowship about setting up an adventure and what James Burke said about this. Maddie, you said?
Yeah, Secure for Maddie.
Well, maybe I could, you know, talk to them also about that situation with him and see if we could set up something for him at that Unitarian. Since I'm a member, maybe they might do two events for the same thing. Because it is for a life, like mm-hmm. Stanley Moore said, so I'm going to look at the paper and see what is out there, which is not much. You know, observing it, I'm going to go look this over and see if anything. Well, there is something going on. It's from 9:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Defensive Driving Course sponsored by the Library, Mitchell, and Greenness Library. And after attending the court, you'll receive a certificate of completion that could be sent to your insurance aid for a possible reduction in your auto's insurance premium. It's $22 a person in the Greenest Library, 2642 East Main Street, Wapner's Falls. So those who want to, you know, try to get their points dropped and you know, get more a better rate for your insurance, I can contact these people in Wapner's Falls and at the Greenest Library at 2642 East Main Street, Wapner's Fort, and it's $22 a person. And let me see, I'm looking, and here's Joe Berner's Natural History Society field trip that will definitely start at 5:30 a.m. And if you could, you know, maybe you still got it on. And then it's Sorority is at the Exposed Bend Natural Preserve, Shady Lane, Main Entrance Parking Lot, Socrates. Like I said, I'm jumping around to see because there ain't really much in the paper. And we're going to your favorite friends at 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. The Free Yoga Pizza Party, recurrent event every Saturday, joint Woman Power Space and My Plate Pizza for a rejuvenated yoga class and pizza. Families, beginner, and children welcome. Mats will be provided. Donation appreciated. Information is Sarah at womenspowerspace.org. My Place Pizza, 322 Main Street, Poughkeepsie. So from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m., the free yoga pizza party. And you can contact our info at Sarah at womenspowerspace.org. My Place Pizza, 322 Main Street, Poughkeepsie. And they also have at 2 p.m., free meditation instruction, ongoing every Saturday, 2 p.m. in the Amaterasu Shrine Room, 60-minute clock, required, no period meditation and spirit. For information, contact Jane Tolan at 845-679-5906, 1012, Kama Triman, I can't say the word, but it's at 33 Meadow Road Road, Meadow Mountain Road, Woodstock. And I'm going to go there and say that we're going to be also having a Saturday night jazz. And I think you know this person, it's Paulin Bill. And it's special, John is special, and Pete Thompson, Stephen Rowland, and Pete Inchhor. I think that's them. It's in Paulin Bill, right here. And maybe you know these people. Yeah, James.
Saturday Night Jazz in Palinville.
Yeah, see if you know that.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that should be exciting. Yeah. Yeah, definitely. If you're around Palinville tonight at 7 p.m., Saturday Night Jazz featuring New York City saxophonist Al Gwart. Yeah, that'll be a good time.
Yes. Yeah. So, because I might, because like I said, at 9:30, I'm going to 9 Franklin Road in Hyde Park to help Marie Quackenbush get the vote out for Bernie. And then I might go down to the train station if I got the time to help up with flyer for Bernie. Then after that, I'm going to a party on 116 Henry Street in Kingston. And that should be my day for today. And then hopefully I got enough energy left to, you know, check out a few of the other sites. And until I get you down the paper, because you now, because, you know, age is catching up with me, I like to take, you know, sleep at night, so I don't really check the paper out that much now until in the morning. So I'll turn over to Stanley and let him tell us what's going around the Hudson. But there is one other thing that's going to happen tomorrow. They're having a masquerade ball vendor. And it's tomorrow at 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. in Abbey Ridge Caterer, Route 17, Route 376, Hope Road Junction. It's by our old friends. You remember our friend we went to for that event at, you know, that Auburn Ridge?
Oh, yeah.
Well, that was happening tomorrow. And so we're going to have to check that out tomorrow. It starts at 11 p.m.
Yeah, that's out in Hope Road Junction, right?
Yes, 11 a.m. 11
a.m.
to 3 p.m.
Okay, out in Hope Road Junction.
Right.
Yeah, they had an excellent thing going on out there at Christmas time. That was beautiful. In fact, I still have that on Facebook, and that's also on YouTube, if you'd like to check out their Christmas events out there.
I didn't know My Place Pizza hosted yoga.
Hmm?
Yeah, that's interesting. Yoga, it's body science. It's how the body systems work together and all. My first impression of yoga, it was in seventh grade, my science teacher was telling us about her yoga classes, and they had to stop letting kids participate because when they would do certain positions,
right,
and they couldn't, like, put their hands together, right, you know, the arms just wouldn't move that far, they started to get a little scared.
Right.
It's fascinating the way that stuff manipulates the body and everything, but I've heard nothing but good things about the benefits of yoga for relieving joint pain,
right,
and muscle stress and things like that. So
there's actually a couple of places here on Main Street that actually do that. There's adult yoga classes, which I'm not familiar with the address, but just further down Main Street,
mm-hmm.
they have adult yoga classes, and then they have the one here at my place, and there's another school of art, which is I believe put on by the Arts of the Mid-Hudson.
Mm-hmm.
They also sponsor one too. So there are several yoga classes that are around, but they're very popular here, and they're very good for you. As mm-hmm. cardio exercise, is very good for you, keep you healthy.
And
that's another, I recommend.
There's another place I've been going to last couple of times called The Living Seed. It's at 521 Main Street, Route 299 in Newport, and then they have meditation, you know, really. I think it just started opening. They had their event January the 1st,
mm-hmm.
New Year's Day, and I went there a couple of times. Like, you get into meditation, the singing,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, you can check them out, too. By an old friend of mine, so, you know, we should, you know, go see if they want to get sponsored, because they have a pretty good audience, and people come there, like yoga, too, and I really like the meditation.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you need to get off the stress of daily life, you know. But you, sometimes, you know, you get so much stress that you got to have something to, and meditation for me just soothes me so much. It relieves that.
Mm-hmm.
And it's also good for your health, too, I've heard.
Mm-hmm.
So now I'll give a turn off to the boss, man.
All right. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. You're listening to WHBW 950 AM. We're looking at 36 degrees and it's calm outside, and we're hoping that light rain and drizzle holds up later on this afternoon, but it's supposed to be quite rainy tomorrow, but that's tomorrow and that's a different day.
It's supposed to be storming all week, I think.
Yeah, so I'm just wanting to push that back as far as possible.
Mm-hmm.
Don't like it when it's wet, don't like it when it's cold. It's just too much. I want to stay in bed and I can't do that. There's just too much to do. It's supposed to make it up somewhere around 45 degrees today, and I can't wait for that, because that's about as warm as I can hope for. But right now we're going to get on with the morning read, and it's about 39 minutes after the hour of 6, and we're going to get on with what's happening right around the city of Poughkeepsie. The Queen City has gone on just a few announcements here. Your community Tai Chi. Now, here's something we was talking about yoga. Now, Tai Chi is an exercise in itself and also defensive art classes. From Monday 6 to 8 at the Mid-Hudson Heritage Center, you can join them for their Tai Chi classes at 317 Main Street, right across the road from the Zero Main Street.
First of all.
Community Tai Chi classes. And also on Sunday, 9 to 10:30 a.m., the Beacon Community Center at 23 West Center Street in Beacon, New York. It's Foreign Principles with Max Saban. And Sunday Beacon location is at 10:30 to 12. Beginners of all levels welcome. For more information, please call 914-475-4397. And that, believe me, Tai Chi, yes, definitely. When I was younger myself, when I was living in Newburgh, it was actually a Taekwondo class that I took, but Tai Chi is, believe me, it's very, very beneficial, and actually it's very, very, very defensive art class.
So what is Tai Chi anyway to us, you know, non-Tai Chiers?
Tai Chi is a Oriental defensive art class, but it's also very beneficial as far as exercise. And also thinking a little bit more out of the box than you'd normally think. There's defensive fighting techniques, and then there's thinking, okay, how to defend yourself, okay. It's like the difference between jiu-jitsu, judo, you have karate, you have so many types of fighting and mental stability. Tai Chi is just one of those.
It's a philosophy that goes with
it's,
it.
It's right.
What's called an
exactly.
Art.
It's a philosophy of fighting. Some of them, like Taekwondo, is defensive. It's not hitting anyone. It's defending yourself. See what I'm saying? It's not being hit. See what I'm saying? Taekwondo is exactly that. Taekwondo is something that you would take along with another fighting technique. Like you would study Taekwondo and Judo, or Taekwondo and Jiu-Jitsu, Taekwondo and Tai Chi. See what I'm saying? But Taekwondo, which would teach you not to get hit. See what I'm saying? It's a defense. It's a defense class. And it's a frame of mind class. See what I'm saying? In case you do get hit. But the whole idea is not to be hit.
Mm.
How to keep yourself from being hit. Whether it be by a fist or a foreign object. See what I'm saying? So that's and just like relieving somebody from a handgun that's being pointed right in your face. How to take it back or turn it on the individual that's putting it in your face. So, with that being said, if you're not sure, attend the class, because it's very interesting. Even if you watch, you might find yourself very interested. But with that being said, on with the morning read. This is Stan Moss, and we're going on with the morning read. The January community meetup meeting at Hudson River Housing Incorporated, Middle Main Street, is Tuesday, January 19th from 6 to 8 at the Mid-Hudson Heritage Center at 317 Main Street, same place right across the street from us. I'm going to try my best to be there. Okay, the topics is going to be the Poughkeepsie Earth Day Planning Session. Okay, help create a collaboration of community diversity and broad deliveries in Poughkeepsie, New York. So I'm going to try to be down there. It looks, just by the photograph, looks like it's going to be taking place in the Pocket Park down at down by the underwear factory. That's just going by the picture that's on the brochure. So that's where the picture was taken, but which is down on Main Street by Cherry. But if you want to find out more information about it, just call 845-454-5176, extension 119. Okay, and but I'm looking forward to that, and that's January 19th from 6 to 8 p.m. All right, and on with the show. The next one is Literacy Connections of the Hudson Valley invites you to change your life. Let our free tutors help you improve your reading, writing, work skills, or English. Call 845-452-8670 today. Okay, and that's Literacy Connections. And we're going to, for more basic knowledge that we are familiar with, these are some of the regular reads here. The Poughkeepsie Plenty Fresh Market, coming to a neighborhood, fresh fruits and veggies and affordable prices. New hours for shopping easier. Family Partnership Center is 11:30 a.m. to 1 p.m., 29 North Hamilton Street, Poughkeepsie. Commerce Square, 4:30 to 6:30 p.m., is 253 Main Street, Poughkeepsie. Green space on the main near market. And Thursday is Interfaith Towers, 10:30 a.m. to 12 p.m., 66 Washington Street, Poughkeepsie, and Maplewood, 4:30 p.m. to 6 p.m. That's at 457 Maple Street, Poughkeepsie, westbound arterial. For more information, it would be at 845-454-3792. We accept SNAP, WIC, Farmers Market Nutrition Programs, and cash. Okay, and that's powered by Dutchess Outreach. Thank you, Mr. Brian Rydell. And we're going to head off into some 501c3s that are doing quite well around the city of Poughkeepsie. The Academy Street Area Partnership, which is shortly known as ASAP, okay, was formed in 2007. And they seek to collaborate with community-minded groups, organizations, businesses, and citizens to build a stronger, more vibrant Poughkeepsie. You can visit them on Facebook at www.facebook.com/AcademyStreetAP. You can get in touch with Lena Marcuso at 131 Academy Street. Just give her a call at 845-337-8552. Okay, and that's ASAP. And we also have one of my favorites. Used to be with these guys here, which is a nonprofit repair program. Rebuilding Together and accepting applications for a 501c3 organizations. For local nonprofit community organizations to apply for and repair services and accessibility modifications to Rebuilding Together Dutchess County, a nonprofit organization that focuses on advocacy and community buildings. Applications will be accepted year-round. You can get in touch with them at www.rtdutchess.org or call 845-454-7310. And that's Rebuilding Together Dutchess County. And there are some wonderful people there. That I can tell you. Did some work for them back in the early 90s. Still have their t-shirt. It's in good shape.
What did you do together?
Actually, I was a painter. And that was when they was doing a lot of work around Main Street, Academy Street, and stuff like that. And their 501c3 was one of the most popular around. And it was really great working with them. They sent a lot of work my way. Mm-hmm. And I did a lot of them. That's when they was changing the businesses over to residential from the second floors up. And a lot of them, such as the record store around the corner, was turned into apartments and stuff like that. It was renovating these for living spaces. Low income,
mm-hmm.
And did a lot of work around.
Sounds like examples of their work are all over.
Yeah.
So, and, good stuff, get involved.
Yeah, and now the city's actually redoing the fronts of the buildings, you know, in a historical fashion, which highlights it. Mm-hmm. And they're actually a lot of the first floors to businesses, you know, so that actually improves the environment too. So you got people living from the second floor up, mm-hmm. in apartments, but the first floor is designated to businesses. So that makes, you know, it levels it out. So you got living, businesses, mm-hmm. businesses along the street level. So it actually works really well that way. I mean, if you want to have that environment, you need the housing and stuff like that, it works. But our next one up is STS is on Saturday, 7 to 8 p.m. You're probably wondering what STS is. It's opiate recovery meetings. Okay, share your past, focus on your future, save your life. Come attend opiates recovery meeting on Saturdays. All are welcome. And the opiate recovery meetings are at Arlington Reformed Church, 22 Raymond Avenue, Poughkeepsie, New York. If you would like to get more information on this organization, please, you can contact them through Secrets 2, that's the number 2, SuccessSync@gmail.com. Their business phone is 845-206-2961. For those who have used opiates for pain relief in the past. That was a big thing at one point in time.
It's easy to get.
But once you're on them, and then you get addicted to them, you know, then you have a problem for sure.
Yes.
But you have to get off of them somehow. Mm-hmm. That's what... one thing I never really approved of, but then again, pain relief is pain relief. Okay, and the next one's put out by MHA, our good friends over there, which I hope to be doing a documentary on very soon, is MHA, Mental Health of America, Dutchess County, Incarcerated Youth and Family Support, Hope for Families, Helping Others Through Personal Experience. You are not alone. As on the second and fourth Monday of each month, 7 p.m. to 8:30 p.m., Mental Health America of Dutchess County, 253 Main Street, Poughkeepsie. For more information, please contact Mrs. Lynn Rogers at 845-473-2500. Her extension is 1343. Free child care is available for ages 4 through 13 on site.
Well, that's especially valuable.
Yes, it is.
Child care is... dealing with that when you're a single parent, I mean that's even worse. So
they have helped me in the past with me and my little girl, and for that I am truly, truly grateful. Mm-hmm. And the next one up is Peoples Incorporated, which is also another wonderful group. The groups and activities at Peoples Incorporated include dual recovery groups, Emotions Anonymous, grief support groups and regular support groups, men and women's wellness groups, mixer groups, spirituality groups, wise mind groups, hope groups, and movie nights. They're located at 126 Ennis Avenue, Poughkeepsie, New York. You can contact them by giving them a call at 845-452-2728. And that's put out by Peoples Incorporated. And one of the biggest organizations that mental health has as far as advocacy and production of mental health is called NAMI, the National Alliance on Mental Illness. And they cover the broadest range of mental health. And NAMI of the Mid-Hudson, you can find help, find hope. The National Alliance on Mental Illness Mid-Hudson chapter offers free education programs and support groups, including Spanish for parents, caregivers, and family of children, adolescents, and individuals that are affected by behavioral, emotional issues, and or mental illness, brain disorders in Dutchess and Ulster counties. We also offer a peer-to-peer class for adults living in recovery and an adult recovery support groups called Connections. For more information, please visit www.namihudson.org or call them at 845-206-9892 and leave a message. They will get back in touch with you.
NAMI, correct?
Yes. Okay, now we're going to go over some counseling center locations. The Hudson Valley Counseling Center locations are as follows. And you have Beacon Counseling Center at 223 Main Street, Beacon, New York, and their phone number is 845-838-4920. They're open between Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 9 to 5, Tuesdays and Thursdays 9 to 9. The Poughkeepsie Counseling Center at 46 Lincoln Avenue, Poughkeepsie, New York, and their phone number is 845-471-6004. Their hours are Monday, Thursday 9 to 8, and Friday 9 to 5. Hyde Park Counseling Center is located at Children's Medical Group, Suite 2. That's 4252 Albany Post Road. Their phone number is 845-233-5935. The hours are Monday and Friday 9 to 5, Tuesdays and Thursdays 9 to 8. The Dover Counseling Center is 6423 Route 55, Wingdale, New York. Their phone number is 845-350-3010. Their hours are Monday through Thursday 9 to 8, Friday 9 to 5. The Rhinebeck Counseling Center is a satellite office. It's located at 187 East Market Street, Rhinebeck, New York. Their phone number is 845-616-5335. Their hours of opening for business is Monday, Tuesday, 12 to 8, Wednesday, 11 to 8, Thursday and Friday, 11 to 5. And if you need to talk, life out of control, friends need help, need someone to talk to, talk or text 845-485-9700 or call toll free 877-485-9700. Dutchess County Helpline app experienced people who care and can help are available every day 24/7. The Helpline service is brought to you by Dutchess County Department of Behavioral and Community Health. And we appreciate every moment that they're there. And I want to also include this before I go on to the rest of the read. Assistance or questions. If you have any questions about your heating bill or need assistance with paying your utility bill, contact the New York State Department of Public Service helpline at 1-800-342-3377. If you are facing an electric or gas shutoff, call the department's hotline at 1-800-342-3355. And that's put out by the New York Natural Gas Outlook. Okay, now for some information on our local services that are available, mainly put out by Family Services, which are providing hope, improving lives, and strengthening our community. And that would be 29 North Hamilton Street, Poughkeepsie, New York. You can get in touch with them 845-452-1110. That's the Family Partnership. And they're also located across our beautiful river at 85 Grand Street, Kingston, New York. And you can get in touch with them over there at 845-331-5641. And that's Family Services. Okay, well, once again, we have something that I am very, very close to, and that's MHA, Mental Health America of Dutchess County, bringing wellness home, care management, community education, family support, support advocacy, homeless services, pros and supported housing. Mental Health of America of Dutchess County is located at 253 Manson Street, Poughkeepsie, New York. And they had actually asked me to do a documentary on them, so I will be getting in touch with them very soon.
So I'm looking forward to that.
So that's another documentary that we'll be doing for YouTube. And also, they was very interested. I went to their Christmas ball that they had at the Grand Hotel, and I had talked to one of the directors there, and they had asked me to actually come over and talk to their director over there about doing one the same way we're doing one over here at Family Partnership. So this is getting bigger and bigger and bigger, which
is a good thing. Information is knowledge. I've always said that on this show, and it is, and I'm glad it's expanding. And this, like I said, once again, looking forward to having a volunteer, because like I said, this thing is just growing and growing and growing. I'm going to need some help with it, and I'm glad we're going to have a volunteer here to do it. It's just more than a radio show. We keep doing what we do even after hours. When we go off to air, the work starts. We come here to share it with you, but the hours go on.
And on. And,
yes, they do. And right now we're about 3 minutes to the hour of 7. You're listening to WHBW, 950 AM. And on with the show. The Hudson Valley Dynamic Counseling is a multidisciplinary, I'm choking up without my coffee. I ain't for the mug in a while. A multidisciplinary approach to improving the quality of life. Now this is a new one. Okay. And these are classes put out by Family Services, Families First of New York, Teen Resources and Activity Center, which is the TRAC program, the Literacy Connections, and Dutchess Outreach, Poughkeepsie Public Library District, and Mental Health Association Living Room. Okay, and you can find out more information on this just by calling Hudson Valley Dynamic Counseling. It's at 224 Church Street, Poughkeepsie, New York. Their phone number is 845-473-7500. Okay, this is a new one, but a very interesting one. So the Hudson Valley Dynamic Counseling Services. That one I'm going to hang on to because that's the only one that I've seen in the information thing, so that's the only one they had. But I guess everybody that's come through there has picked up one of these. I'm glad I got one before they got gone. So, all right, the next one up, this is another very, very, very busy office here because they put out a lot of flyers, so this is very good information. This is the Battered Women's Services, helping victims of domestic violence for over 30 years. The Crisis and Information Hotline. You can contact them at 845-5550. It's also put out by Family Services. You are not alone. Help is available. If you are being abused or know someone who is, we can help. And that's Family Services, the 24-hour hotline. It's 845-485-5550. And on. And this is Mid-Hudson Interpretive Services, providing interpretive services and services for the deaf and the hard of hearing. Open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Located at 82 Washington Street, Suite 214, Poughkeepsie, New York. Their phone number is 845-452-3913. And that's put out by the Mid-Hudson Interpretive Services. And Taconic Resources, a service center for independent living. My son's mother used to work there. She was a counselor there. To promote independent and integration into society for people with disabilities, that's located at 82 Washington Street, Suite 214 in Poughkeepsie. And the number is 845-452-3913. And believe me, this is a very good organization. They do handle all of these that I'm reading, and they're provided by Family Services. It's the same as Crime Victims Assistance Program, providing advocacy, counseling, and forensic nursing services to victims of crime in Dutchess County. 24-hour rape crisis and crime victims hotline, 845-452-7272, and it's also put out by Family Services.
They offer mental health counseling, PTSD.
Yes, and these are our friends here at Dutchess Outreach. And for more information, just give them a shout out at 845-454-3792 or visit their website at www.dutchessoutreach.org. Okay, they're located at 29 Hamilton Street, Suite 222, Poughkeepsie, New York, 12601.
Now, PTSD can be tricky. It can kind of sneak in.
And it's very hard to detect. It really is, because it goes through cycles back and forth, back and forth.
It's almost like a split personality. Mm-hmm. It's lots of hard to track down. But PTSD?
Oh, yes, because I think they said now they might have a they might treat it now with medical marijuana.
Yeah, there's a lot of issues that are so controversial around it and how to treat it. But to me, that's just like the flyer I read earlier, you know, about opiates. You know, what are you going to do once you get a person addicted to something? Mm-hmm. I would rather sit down and have a person addicted to counseling and conversation than I would have a person addicted to any type of drug that's going to end up in a rehab.
Yeah, but I don't think marijuana is addictive, is it?
It's not. Addiction is a particular chemical process. It doesn't really happen with marijuana, but it can be habit forming.
Yeah, it's not necessarily this is my opinion. I don't think it should be put as a class A drug. Okay, it's not a drug that you would. Like I said, this is my opinion. It's not a drug that you would start a wage of war against drugs on. You know, it's mm-hmm. it's not like heroin. Mm-hmm. It's not like the rest of them that are class A drugs. I think it's classified wrong with it. You know, so I don't think it's a class A drug like heroin and the rest of them and crack and coke and all that stuff. I think it would probably be a class C or something like that, just a misdemeanor drug. It's not a class A felony drug. You know, mm-hmm. it's something that's a recreational, if anything. But, it's not something that, you know, you 25 to life after three strikes is no. You know, it's not something like that. It's not that drastic. You know,
to me, that's
like a bad parenting problem, you know. A person, you know, holding up a bank.
Can you believe the whole, you're familiar with the affluenza teen story?
Mm-hmm.
Can you believe that's gone as far as it has? Apparently the mother was arraigned in court the other day. She was complaining about the food at the prison.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, she wasn't prepared for it. It's like, I thought this was going to be a 5-course meal.
Oh, well, yeah.
Yeah, right.
But this is like when I say about marijuana, the same as, they actually say it should be cut dry the same as alcohol, you know.
Yeah, I thought the butler was going to be wearing a bow tie.
Not a badge.
Yeah, right.
I mean, alcohol I think is worse than... You know, marijuana, and I know smoking is worse than, because that's happened for them too. And that's it. Smoking is just addicting, I ought to know.
Right.
So, you know, you're going to classify those two drugs legit, you know, marijuana should be in the same category.
That's like a hookah pipe, okay? Mm-hmm. Now, you see stores, this has always killed me. You see stores all the time selling these big hookah pipes, you know, these five and six things on, you know, 5 or 6 straws or whatever you call them, you know. Mm-hmm. And I'm sitting there looking at these. I said, okay, why? Why are they selling these things in drugstores?
Mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm.
I said, now, first of all, they're not selling, you know, marijuana in these in pharmacies. Right. And nobody really smokes what's in them. You can't smoke anything but tobacco in them.
Yes. Right?
And so why are they selling everywhere when nobody buys what's normally smoked now?
Mm-hmm.
So I don't understand it. Now, if these hookah pipes were sold in, say, a medical marijuana shop, you would have to have 5 or 6 people sitting around doing this, you know, in a room. And that doesn't mean that you're sitting around in a medical marijuana shop with 5 or 6 taking the same meds at the same time. I don't understand why there's so many shops got so many of them and the stuff still ain't legal.
It's kind of funny to imagine a hospital buying the marijuana paraphernalia in bulk.
Yeah, right.
For the patients.
It just doesn't, because if you ride down Main Street, you see them in just about every other window shop. You know, there's big hookah pipes. And it's like, who's buying these? Or they, you know, it looks like a big lamp stand, you know?
Yes.
I want to put a lamp, a bulb in one of them and a lampshade on it. Yeah, that'd be a pretty lamp, you know?
You know, no lamps.
You know, I don't know. Somebody's using something.
Yes. You know? I mean... And I know you can't smoke that much tobacco in one of those hookah, whatever you call them.
Right, and have a commercial on, you know, one of these hookah pipes is worth 100 cigarettes, you know, mm-hmm. you know, this is the
Anyway, that conversation was out. But back to the morning read. I want to finish this up real quick because it's already 8 minutes after the hour or seven. Veterans Housing and Services, Supported Services for Veterans Families, which is a very, very, very good cause. And these guys do a lot of good work for our vets. The SSVF office is located at 38 North Clinton Street, Poughkeepsie, New York. You can give them a call at 845-232-5754. You can fax them at 845-337-4197. Okay, and they can give you information and give you a hand to help. Hudson River Housing exists to improve the lives and communities. Our mission is to build strong, sustainable communities by developing and preserving the quality of affordable housing and helping families and individuals obtain and maintain housing through education, advocacy, and support services for veterans. And that's a beautiful thing. Mm-hmm. So our vets do need help. Also, the next up on the list, this is where it starts to get a little bit heart-tugging for me, because I can relate to it. I have a teenage girl. Teen dating violence. Okay. This is put out by the Smith Grace Smith House at 1 Brookside Avenue, Poughkeepsie, New York. You can contact them at 845-452-7155, or just hit them up on gracesmithhouse.org. There's a long list of things you can I could read to you on how to detect things to pick up on. I'll just read a couple of them off here. Does the person you love tell you that other guys, girls they don't trust, including not you? Text you constantly because they miss you, act jealous and possessive, accuse you of cheating or flirting, try to keep you from being around friends and family, constantly put you down, make fun of you in front of others, including jokes at your expense, destroy or take your personal property or sentimental items, cheat on you, push, hit, slap, punch, kick, or bite you, force you to have sex against your will, or demand sex you're uncomfortable with. These are all the red flags that you may be in an abusive relationship. If so, call 845-471-3033. And that's put out by the Grace Smith House under the title Teen Dating Violence.
It can be difficult to get help, because it's not uncommon for victims to just be ignored or not believed.
Exactly,
so,
and
you gotta reach out for help, and it's there.
Yes, and I believe Grace Smith House is the one that actually covers the large majority of when it comes to women and female teens that cover, because it's so out of control, and it's usually kept silent. Mm-hmm. It's like the silent destructive measure against women of all ages. They have another one here. It's called Nobody Deserves to Be Abused. It's also put out by the Grace Smith House. And like I said, the Grace Smith House Incorporated is located at 1 Brookside Avenue, Poughkeepsie, New York. You can contact them at www.gracesmithhouse.org, or you can call them at 845-471-3033. We can help. 90 to 95% of domestic violence survivors are women. 28% of all annual violence against women is perpetrated by intimates. That's intimates, not inmates. Intimates.
Yes.
Okay, domestic violence is statistically consistent across racial and ethnic boundaries. Each year, an estimated 3.3 million children are exposed to violence by family members against their mothers or female caregivers. In homes where partners abuse occurs, children are 1,500 times more likely to be abused. Female homicide victims are more than twice as likely to have been killed by an intimate partner than a male homicide victims. 70% of intimate homicide victims are female.
I think I mentioned the last time, A victim of domestic violence is most likely to be killed when she tries to leave.
Exactly.
So it's, you will often need help to escape from that situation.
Yes.
The help is there. Please go get it.
Yes. Yeah, because the person wants the male partner wants to control. That's their basic motive.
Yes, that's how
and
they
once
control.
You try to leave, they lose that feeling of control. They say
they have nothing else to lose.
Right.
Yeah. So if you have to, ladies, just say you're walking to the store. But just remember, Gray Smith House is, as they say, an open door for victims of domestic violence. That is their logo. Gray Smith House is an open door to domestic violence. And they're located at 1 Brookside Avenue, Poughkeepsie, New York. And you can give them a call, once again, at 845-471-3033 if you are suffering from that issue. And I hope and pray that you are not.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Like I said, these things really, really, really tug on the heartstrings. That just took me back for a second. Once again, NAMI, N-A-M-I, Advocates for Access to Services Support and Research is steadfast in its commitment to raise awareness and build a community of hope for all of those in need. Specific objectives include advocacy for the support of individuals with mental illness, family members, and other loved ones, and eradicate stigma, support research and cause and treatment of mental illness, to educate the public about mental illness, the work to improve public and private support systems and individuals with mental illness, and to promote NAMI, N-A-M-I, signature programs. You can get in touch with the NAMI Mid-Hudson local affiliate at the by giving them a call at 845-206-9892. Or you can hit them up on the web at www.NAMIMIDHUDSON.org. And I was so glad that they're there. And if you're a young student looking to better your career, you can always get in touch with Glenmont Job Corp Center. Okay, Glenmont Job Corp Center is located at 822 River Road, Glenmont, New York. What to find and more about, okay? And you can check them out online at www.recruiting.jobcorps.gov and get in touch with the administrator counselor at 800-733-JOBS, J-O-B-S, and that is 5627. So that's 800-733-5627. Success lasts a lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and they're also located at 1 Civic Center Plaza, Suite 530 in Poughkeepsie. And their number here in Poughkeepsie is 845-473-0605. Okay, and also we have one here. I keep bringing this up. This comes all the way from Georgia. Okay, alcohol damage, the teen brain. SaveBrains.org. Okay, parents are the number one influence in a child's decision not to drink. Okay, in other words, if a child sees his parents drinking, chances are he won't.
Yes.
That is so true, because a child does not like to see a parent drunk. They don't like to get beat on by parents that are drunk. They just don't like the atmosphere. What you can do to prevent underage drinking. There's a long list here. I've read them before. I'll just go over a couple of them real quick. Eat dinner together regularly. Be caring and supportive. Maintain open lines of communication. Set no drinking rules and consequences. Be consistent with them. Surround your child with positive role models. Teens need parents to be parents, not drinking partners. Keep track of the alcohol in your home. Count it and lock it up. Check in with your teens about their plans and ask about alcohol. Be up and ready at curfew. Talk with your teens about their night. Learn the signs and symptoms of alcohol abuse. If problems occur, get help promptly. SaveBrains.org is funded by the Georgia Department of Behavioral Health and Developmental Disabilities, Office of Prevention Services and Programs. And that's who it's funded by, Georgia Department of Health. Don't mind reading that here, because help comes where you can get it. Okay, the next one is the Lexington Center for Recovery Adolescent Program. Okay, how to get started. All treatment begins with a comprehensive evaluation designed to identify problems and concerns for a young person and family. Following the evaluation, the therapist will work with the client and family to determine their goals and treatment. To schedule an evaluation, call the Dutchess County Helpline at 845-485-9700. Or contact us directly at the Lexington Center for Recovery, 41 Page Park Drive, Poughkeepsie, New York, at 845-486-2950. And Lexington Recovery, that's, I'm trying to remember exactly where that's at. I used to have a friend that went there, but it helped them out really well. They took their child there. But,
Lexington, I believe that's a little farther up. That's, I think it's past Saugerties.
Yeah. They have one in Poughkeepsie here down. I was trying to remember where it was at. But, okay, the next one up anyway is the Teen Parenting Program. This one right here is a good one. Keep your children safe. For more information, please call 845-454-0595. And they're located at 35 Van Wagner Road, Poughkeepsie, New York. And like I said, the phone number is 845-454-0595. And you can hit them up at www.facebook.com/the Center for the Prevention of Child Abuse. And I'm all for the prevention of child abuse, so we're going to definitely hang on to that one. The next one up is Mediation Center for Dutchess County. What is bullying? Okay, there are some signs for the child bullying. But if you do have a bullying problem in your home with your children, please contact the mediation of Dutchess County for Anti-Bullying Initiative. Their number is 845-471-7213. A comprehensive approach to bullying prevention and intervention. You can hit them up at www.dutchessmediation.org. Okay, and they have several programs for the Dutchess County Department of Mental Hygiene Helpline is 845-485-9700. And Legal Services of Hudson Valley is 845-471-0058. Family Services Incorporated Crimes Victims Assistance Vote Program. Hudson Valley LGBTO Community Center is 845-331-5300. And GLSEN of the Hudson Valley is 914-588-1306. Do not like bullying at all. And you have the Partners to Prevent People with Special Needs, Guides to Reporting Abuse and Neglect for Children with Special Needs. If you have this situation going on, please contact the New York State Justice Center for the Protection of People with Special Needs. This publication is available in alternative formats. Upon request, please contact the Justice Center. Information for referral staff. Call toll-free 1-800-624-4143. Or you can email info@justicecenter.ny.gov. And that's for partnering to protect people with special needs. And last but not least is the Healthy Families. Are you expecting parenting support for you and your baby? And the locations are in Poughkeepsie. Our friends at 29 North Hamilton Street, Suite 209, Poughkeepsie, New York. You can give them a call at 845-452-3387. And Beacon is 333 Fishkill Avenue, Beacon, New York. The number is 845-838-2518. And Kingston is 15 Railroad Avenue, Suite 401, Kingston, New York. Their phone number is 845-339-8551. And Ellenville is 221 Canal Street, Ellenville, New York. Their number is 845-647-7743. Or you can call toll-free 1-800-811-3914. Their hours are from Monday to Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. After-hour appointments are available upon request. Visit us online at www.institute2000.org. And that's it for today's morning read. And may you have a blessed day. Right now, it's 18 minutes after the hour of 7. You're listening to WHBW 950, the voice of the city of Poughkeepsie and the happenings around the Hudson Valley.
And so now I'm going to turn it over to James Burke again, because I found a couple of interesting things that James Burke would be very specified on. And he wanted to say something about them before I go to the Sunday morning read.
Sure. Are you familiar with the Town Crier Cafe in Beacon?
Yes.
Yes, I've had a good fortune of performing there a couple of times. Let's see here. This, Sunday, January 10th, at 7:30 p.m. at the Town Crier Cafe in Beacon, they're going to hold a fundraiser for the American Center for Folk Music. This is a new thing that they're just starting up. They don't have a physical location for it just yet, but it's been envisioned as a hub for celebrating folk pioneers and sustaining the folk music process. It's going to be somewhere in Beacon. They don't have a place to put it just yet, but the proprietor of the Town Crier Cafe, Phil Saganer, is a member of the American Center for Folk Music's founding board of directors, and they will be hosting a fundraiser tomorrow at 7:30, featuring local and regional musicians such as Guthrie's Ghost, Beacon's Youthful Solar Sound Band, singer Susan Basso, and special guests. And that sounds like it will be a great night for celebrating America's music.
Yes, it would.
That's wonderful.
That would be something I would like to record, actually, for the YouTube.
Yeah, I just want.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, I got a feeling we might be doing a lot of traveling again.
Also coming up tonight.
We need sponsorship. I'm going to just put it like that. We need sponsorship. And I'm not trying to put it out there, but we don't really have the funding for it. Boy, we got to do
lots coming up.
Yeah, I know. There's a lot of things coming up that can benefit the city as well as what we're trying to do. What we do is on a volunteer basis. But getting around the valley is hard to do, and it gets expensive. Mm-hmm. You know, the Facebook that we do is free. The radio station, this is volunteer. The YouTube, you know, maintaining that. The documentaries, everything that we do is these things we do because we care. But the physical part of getting back and forth to do these things, it's hard to get up and down and around the Hudson Valley in order to do them. And it's the involvement that comes with a price. But we don't have the admissions. We don't all have the, like myself, and I'll be straight up front and very blunt. I don't even have a car. See what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That really puts a hurt on things. I walk here to the station. I walked to the partnership. I walked to mental health in order to start this other documentary program. But the simple fact is getting around and into these shows in order to record them. It makes it very difficult. So this is the reason the sponsorship drive has to take place. We need sponsorship. We need to get out there. There's a lot of things I'd like to do. But if we can't, we're going to end up being cut right back down to nothing. Everybody wants to be involved, but involvement comes with a price, and without support, you don't do much. You know, you can only do with what you have.
Mm-hmm.
And that's basically the bottom line. How long you last. We've been doing this for a while. But I'm going to go and take it as far as I can and keep going as long as I can. But I'd hate to start falling off. The YouTube account is doing excellent. The radio station, as far as I know, is doing really well. I get a lot of compliments on it just about everywhere I go. Mm-hmm. The Facebook is doing really well, but it's about supporting the radio show. So the sponsorship drive is going to have to have some impact. I mean,
That's why we go places, we try to get the sponsorship to on top. Like he said, I do have a car, but like he said, sometimes they're like multiples. And like I'm trying to do today, this is like last night when I went to sleep, I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to do everything in a time period. It's really hard. And so what I'm doing, and I go to these places, we don't take pictures, but also we're looking for sponsors too, because, something got to come back our way. So, you can go back to what you were saying about this other event you were talking about.
Yeah, I feel you guys on this, traveling around to perform sometimes. It's an 18-hour day.
Yes,
it is. All the traveling, it's long. I realized when you're in entertainment, it's when you get to the show and you're there, that's not the job. That's the fun part. That's why you do this. It's the traveling. That's the job.
Exactly.
That's the job part of it. So, also, I wanted to mention tonight, Saturday, at the Walk and Roll Cafe, Mill Hill Road in Woodstock, Joey Eppard and friends will be performing. Joey Eppard is a stunningly gifted guitar player. He blends rock with flamenco technique,
right?
Finger picking and everything. I've had the opportunity to hear him perform several times. I even had the opportunity to perform with him. This is going back about 10 years when I was playing saxophone. I was in the horn section that night, and Joey was subbing in on bass.
Right.
So I had the opportunity to work with him and rehearse with him a little bit. He is a fantastic musician, great singer, too, lots of feeling and nuance, very creative songwriter, and just a real pleasure to listen to on the guitar. So he and his band will be performing up in Woodstock tonight. Beacon, Woodstock, Poughkeepsie, Kingston, Rosendale, there's great stuff going on all over the Hudson Valley.
Right.
I think that's the takeaway here.
Well, that sounds like a wonderful night. It really does. But the big thing here, I'm gonna try to get some of this. Like I said before, I'm gonna try to get some of this entertainment locked down here in Poughkeepsie. And there are a few places that do host some talent here. I'd like to see some talent perform at several places on venues here in Poughkeepsie. I know they come in and they'll play like one place in Poughkeepsie.
Mahoney's, yes. Mahoney's.
Yeah. Mahoney's being one of them. But while they're here, I'd like to see them play at more than one place while they're here in the area. because I honestly think that they if these places were in place, they would play at multiple places. Like even if it was to play, I'll put it this way: when the Civic Center, okay, when you would have like a big name talent come to town. You would have people who would come and play in the Civic Center, and then they would turn around and they'd play the Chance. See what I'm saying? Back in the day. I remember when Hall & Oates, I did a Hall & Oates concert one time, because I used to work at the Civic Center and set up chairs and stuff like that for wrestling events. But actually, we set up for wrestling events all the time back when WWE and WWF back in the early days. All
but the wrestlers still around.
The wrestlers used to actually live in the hotel up here. Hulk Hogan and the rest of them lived in this hotel up here because this was one of their home bases. Okay, you would see them on Main Street just as easily as you'd see them anywhere else. You know, this was one of their home wrestling events. It was here. It was in Glens Falls. Then of course they had the one over in Connecticut. You know, there was like five arenas that they wrestled in all the time, the WWF. And that was back in the day. You know, that was back in the day. But they always wrestled here. You'd run into these people all the time. But back in the day when these entertainers came to town, not only would they play there, but after they was done, you would end up seeing them down here at the Chance. Or you would see them over at the Barlavon while they was here, you know, and they would play their major venue there, you know. Then they would end up the following weekend or two or three nights later, they'd play at one of the smaller clubs, you know. And they did that while they was here, you know. And something like that, I think, would, you know, really shine for even the lesser known artists, you know. Why you have them here, you know, they can make a circuit round. And I think that would benefit not only the artists themselves, you know, it's just the same thing on a smaller level, you know. The city would be benefited out of it, the businesses would benefit out of it, the artists would benefit out of it. They become more well known in the area before they leave the area. Instead of having to bounce up and down the river all the time, they would play more venues in that particular town and then move on. Like you could play the ballroom at the Grand Hotel, and then you could play Mahoney's, and then you play another spot. You like three spots out of a venue in one city, and then move on to the next city or whatever, you know, and do that like a tour, just like a mini tour through the Hudson Valley. And people would say, yeah, I've seen them before, here, 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 here. Or if you liked them, seeing them there, you had an opportunity to say, well, I'm going to take my family to go see him over here because I enjoyed him when I seen him over there, you know. And you could start gathering a little crowd, start following you around, and people start saying, yeah, that was really cool. I'm going to download that app. I'm going to buy that album. I'm going to buy that CD, you know, and stuff like that. So it's like the old days when you had, you know, they had people following your tour around, you know. You started having followers that way, and your name started growing quicker. But you get the idea. It's just like a miniature tour,
right?
You know, because some people are just that good. It enhances the talent. It's good for business, and it's just the whole nine yards. You just enhance everything that you get around. So not only does all the businesses have good talent coming through their businesses, it's good for the talented individuals or bands or whatever to be well known in that area. So you just not just pop in here from there, here to there, here to there. You got them to come and do a small tour, and then go on and do a small tour.
Okay. And what I do, like when I do around the Mid-Hudson, is not only talking about event around the Mid-Hudson, like Stanley said, he's trying to get the music industry, he's trying to get the artists back into the Poughkeepsie. I'm doing around the whole Mid-Hudson, got like Beacon, got the other side. Also, we're trying to get like these sponsors, because if we get sponsors from here, We get sponsored from Beacon, we get sponsored from Newport's and Kingston. That make this show bigger, and then we could produce more. It's like a tidal wave. You get more people connected to the radio station, more information will come out, the more people want to jump on. Mm-hmm. And that's what we're doing. You know, like, you here is a very valuable presence because you know a lot of the artists involved, which we are novices, we don't. And you know who, you know, which one to go to, who is going to be the one that the crowd want to follow. Mm. And, you know, that's why you're such a valuable asset to our station.
Thank you.
And, like I said, there's a few things I want to get back before we run out of the hour.
Sunday read.
Yeah. So I'm going to go to this. Okay, like 8 p.m. tonight, I think you talked about that, Lorna Hope and the Art Tones.
That's right.
And you talked about them. Okay. So, I will bring up that there's still that art school in Riverside. Riverside. Pan Christie Art School and that 419 Riverside Art School and it's on Riverside Road. And you can still go online and check it out. Check her out. She's a wonderful teacher. She's an MBA in art. She do one-on-one class. You know, she have a small class up to 6 people, and she give you extra directions. And just check her online and see, because I think you enjoy it. And she is very personal too. And let's see. Now I'm gonna go to Sunday, because there is a few things I will talk about, you know, tomorrow. Besides the masquerade ball vendor in Hopewell Junction, there is 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. art reception, Suburban Landscapes. Oil and Charcoal Art by Terry Strauss. Exhibit through February the 28th. Information is to call 845-569-4997 or go online at www.karpeles.com. And KARPELES, Manuscript Library Museum, 94 Broadway, Newburgh, New York. So that is 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. art reception at the Suburban Landscape. And that Carpent Manuscript Library Museum, 94 Broadway, Newburgh. And 2:30 p.m. is in right here, Poughkeepsie. The impact of slavery and the maturation the proclamation in New York. Dr. Cheryl D. Wilson is the author of the New York City African Slave Owner, a Social and Material Cultural History. Dr. Wilson lectures and writes on the subject of the African presence in colonial early New York and the slave African presence in the North. Is in the auditorium at 105 Market Street, Poughkeepsie. So anyone who's getting, you know, interested in black culture and what slavery did in New York and maybe and also in Poughkeepsie, this would be very informative to everybody, to people interested in it. Is at the auditorium, 105 Market Street, Poughkeepsie, New York. It starts at 2:30 p.m. And last but not least, on Sunday, 6 p.m., Swing Dance, the Shorty King Rhyme Review. From 6 to 6:30 p.m., beginner's lessons at 6:30 to 9 p.m. Dance, everyone welcome. Arlington Reform, 22 Raymond Avenue, Poughkeepsie, New York, 12603. Sponsored by the Hudson Valley Community Dances. And information online at www.hudsonvalleydance.org or call 845-255-0614. So that's 6 p.m. Swing Dance to Shorty King Rhyme Review at 6 to 6:30 p.m. at the, Arlington Reform Church, 22 Raymond Avenue, Poughkeepsie, New York. And so we'll turn it back to Stanley.
Okay, I'm just going to go over real quick the same thing this morning. It's about 18 minutes to the hour, right? It's right now it's 37 degrees outside. We got a
It's calm outside. The wind's running about 5 miles an hour. It's supposed to get up to around 45 degrees this morning or later on today. We hope the light rain drizzle holds off till later on. You're listening to Happens Around Hudson Valley. And on WHVW 950 AM, the voice of the city of Poughkeepsie. I hope you have a beautiful, beautiful January 9th. It's Saturday. We're covering around the Hudson Valley with Mr. Derek Roberts and covering music, concerts. We'd like to thank Mr. James Burke for covering those, the entertainment and the fundraisings. And around the city of Poughkeepsie, I'm Stan Moss. Today is our first sponsorship meeting day, so we'll be getting back to you on that real soon. Meanwhile, I'd like to remind you that WHVW 950 AM still has its hats and t-shirts are on sale. The hats go for $5, the t-shirts go for $20. They're all embroidered with hearts and soul of American music. If you can get in touch with us, we will happily get one out to you. I would like to still say happy birthday to an old friend of mine, Mr. Billy Heron, and say hi to his lovely wife, Miss Glenn Heron, after 40 years. They were high school sweethearts then, and they're still together, and you don't hear of that too often, so I'd like to give them a shout out on YouTube. And thumbs up. You guys weren't meant to be together then. You're still together now. You can't get much more blessed than that. You have beautiful grandkids, and thanks for the picture over the Christmas holidays. You look a lot like Santa Claus, and that's why I put that comment on Facebook. So appreciate the pictures. Go get a frame. Okay? So give me a call sometime. Happenings around the Hudson Valley. We'll still be covering the My Place Pizza open mic night. Right now it's on hold. So if you get in touch with Pat Fitzgerald over at My Place Pizza when that's going to start taking place again, please just find out from him, because you'll find out as fast as I do.
And they also have yoga.
Yeah, and yes. they also have yoga classes over there, so you have one, more than one reason to get in touch with him. Yoga is very beneficial for the heart, the body, the soul, and the mind.
Mm-hmm.
So we recommend that you do that. I'm looking forward to finding out more about the Waterfront Advisory Committee. I hope that's a volunteer organization, because I'm going to go ahead and get my resume together, and I'm going to submit that and hopefully get on the City Advisory Committee for the development of the waterfront, and hopefully that gets accepted, and put all my list all my chairmanships over the past several years, the past 22 years involvement as a volunteer. Hopefully that'll be enough to get me onto a volunteer position with them, and they'll accept that. I would love to work closely with the mayor and the city council on that. And once again, I'd like to thank Mr. Nicholas Galou from Vassar College. He's the interim director of the field work and lecturer in psychology at Vassar, for having Miss Kelsey Cox get in touch with me yesterday about doing an internship this spring with us for her college credits. I'm looking forward to her. She's worked with Mr. John Flowers, the late Mr. John Flowers, for a couple of years. And I think this would be suitable for her to give us a hand, along with the YouTube, the Facebook, the radio show, and the documentaries that we have set up. I know she was spending some time last night going over the documentaries on YouTube last night to catch up with the shows and the programs.
Mm-hmm.
Jared, we welcome you to the show. We're looking forward to you coming back, and we will get together. Like I said, we'll meet up either here at the station, we'll meet up at the house, but I'm looking forward to introducing you to the crew, and I think you'll fit right in. I'm looking right here at an empty seat. It's got your name on it, and you're going to fit right in good with these guys, and we got a good bunch here, and things have a way of going full circle, and John Flowers, he was a major part of us being here, and this is here, that's why we're here, and this is why we do what we do, because we love it, and I'm going to turn it over to Mr. James Burke with the talents of him and his musical instruments. Here you go, Mr. Burke. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you. Wanted to end today with one of my favorite songs. My name is James Burke. You can find me on Facebook and SoundCloud under the name James Burke Songs. That's all one word. And in case you missed it earlier, I'll be performing this Tuesday at Taste Buds Cafe in Red Hook, along with the highly original Matthew Kabalkin. And one of the great things about the Taste Buds Cafe is that there's a monthly charity that they support, and this month it is A Cure for Maddie. And if you want to find out more about that, and also the illness that she is afflicted with, curejm.org. JM is an autoimmune disease that basically the body attacks its own skin. It's a pretty awful condition, and it's a rare disease, so there's not much being done in the way of research. So if you'd like to get involved, please check out the website. And if you're in the area, stop by Tuesday night at 7, and hopefully we can raise some money for a good cause. Alright, I just want to end today's show with a chorus of one of my favorite songs. This is jazz standard, Wrap Your Troubles in Dreams.
Beautiful chorus, beautiful music.
Weekend, everybody. Thank you for listening.
All right, that was really great. Thank you, sir.
I can't wait to hear the opening song, because if it sounds anywhere as good as that did, that was truly great.
Yes, that's definitely something we have to go listen to.
Give this man a hand.
We did. He's one of a kind.
Ladies and gentlemen. The fantastic Mr. James Burke. I really appreciate that. We are always discussing just how things are, and there's so many sad things in the world, but nothing can lift you up like music can. And there's just some artists that take you and bring you back out of it, and Mr. Burke is one of them.
Exactly.
So if you get a chance to go see this man perform, I really, really recommend that you do. The Maddie cause is definitely a cause worth helping out. If I ever get a chance of having someone on the show to speak on it, I will.
Well, James said, it's so rare that probably no one even knows why it is.
Right. If I could find somebody to speak on the fundraising event, or or the process or something, I really would. Because, like I said, knowledge is information, and I myself, I like to seek knowledge. Usually, I stumble across it, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And if I was actually come across somebody that knew about the fundraising and exactly more about the disease itself,
I would. You know, I would love to have them on the show. We've had several people here, and I have talked to them, even right down to the hypnotist, the terminally that does the hypnosis for the terminally ill.
Adjoa.
Yes, and I was fascinated by what he done. And actually, that I wasn't even aware that you could do that. I was aware of people, you know, going under hypnosis for quit smoking, certain habits, stuff like this, but I didn't know that you could undergo hypnosis for terminal ill patients to help them, like cancer and stuff like this.
Yeah.
But this is what this guy does, and you know, and the more and more I talked to him, the more and more I was amazed. He even was capable of doing this over Skype, over the computer,
mm-hmm.
you know. And I was like, this was totally news to me. I mean, you know, to hypnotize somebody to start with, but to be able to do it over a computer, over Skype, you know, it was just something I had never heard of before.
Mm-hmm. And but, I talked to him just last Sunday and told him to come back on the show.
Right. I told him myself. I said, look. I've smoked cigarettes since I was a teenager. I said, look, but I've cut down a lot. And I've tried patches and stuff like that. But the drawback to that, I'm gonna be honest with everybody. I do still smoke cigarettes occasionally, but the thing is, I've tried these patches and pills, but I also have this thing in my chest.
Yeah.
I can't use patches because they don't interfere with the meds. They interfere with this thing in my chest, which is a vagus nerve implant. It's a VNS. It's a vagus nerve stimulator, which that's the reason I carry this magnet around on my belt. It stops seizures in its tracks. And it's like a pacemaker except it's wired up to the brain.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But I can't take anything that you know defers with that. So with that being said, as it hypnosis might be a trick. So I was going to actually try to give him a call and say, look, how much do you charge for this hypnosis thing to quit smoking cigarettes? You know, just get this out of my way. I'm getting too old to be huffing and puffing and smoking like a broken stove. You know.
I can talk to him tomorrow if he comes to you and Terry.
Yeah, do that. Don't call me.
Let me talk to him tomorrow.
Me and my wife are the same way. You know, she's not a big smoker or anything, but she don't like me to see me go out and take breaks. I'm gonna go outside and have a cigarette, whatever. You know.
I think he lived right above me. He's got like a house there. I see him go. So I think he lives above me. So. I'm going to talk to him tomorrow. I'm going to talk to my reverend about this form we have to do for you know who. And let me, I'll remember that, okay?
Yeah, it's just that.
There's certain things I will remember for, you know, Stanley and James and a few other people. I will keep that in my mind. Other times my mind is like in Pluto land. It's just gone.
Very well put. Pluto land, I like that.
What was neat about the probe they sent Pluto's way? You know, the great pictures we got of Pluto?
Yeah.
We have a better, well, at least I do now, of its size. It would fit in Australia.
Right.
The whole thing. I didn't realize Pluto was that tiny.
Yeah, that's why they tried to downgrade it.
Yeah.
But I seen in one of my emails that this, one of the guys that had like, was working on a satellite thing with Pluto,
mm-hmm.
is that the lead guitar with Queen.
Oh yeah, Brian May.
Yeah.
He, isn't that neat about him? He got all this money from his career as a musician, but instead of just retiring, he went back to school and now he's an astrophysicist.
Right.
Yeah, there's work ethic and then
There's only one thing, there's only, speaking of Pluto, although it's the, well, I'm going to say ninth planet. Okay, I'm gonna go out on that limb.
Yeah.
You know, that's the way it was in the books when I was in school.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
The ninth planet. Okay, now it's the moon.
Is it?
Yeah. Well, then,
I mean, they downgraded again.
No, they made up a new term for it. It's a planetoid object.
Yeah.
A toy?
Yeah,
it's a planet.
Yeah. Yeah. Because at first, the first it went from a planet, they downgraded it to a moon,
And then you had an outrage about you can't downgrade Pluto.
And I was like, a moon. Moon is a derivative of a revolving object around a planet. I said, what planet is it revolving around? I said that there's no planet even close to it. I said, so how did it become a moon? A moon to what? You know. I said it would just be a stellar object from outside the Kuiper belt that just is there, you know. So it's an icy ball that's just outside the Kuiper belt, you know. Mm. So I didn't. And then the planetoid thing is just a whole new. Let's make up a name and come. We got to call it something before somebody comes and riots in front of the Astrological Society.
But there's so many people. So you know, they still figure Pluto as Walt Disney.
Yeah. It's
sometimes they go out of date. I still think of nine planets.
I think
it was one when I was a kid.
Yeah, I think they need to start reprinting the history books and science books and let the kids start carrying them. You know, and say, look, let's just wipe the slate clean because we done changed science, we changed history, we changed this, we changed this. Just start all over again.
I think they made social story obsolete.
Yeah, I mean.
They have them all on their Kindles.
Yeah. Does everybody get this? You get this tablet here that's hooked up to everything, and that stays in that grade class, and then you move up to the next grade, and that tablet stays with that grade, you know. And then in the next grade, when you graduate up to from 9th to 10th, you get a 10th grade tablet, and that's got that information on it. And the teachers, which they can't afford anyway, just stay at home. The homework's already downloaded. You know,
yeah,
the teacher got a week. Go find a job.
Yeah, but the thing is, my Kindle is Barnes and Noble, where we go buy what is called a book, and take it home and read it. I don't do Kindle.
Right.
I want to see it.
I'm not an iPad fan. I'm not an iPad fan, I'm not an iBook fan, or anything else. I think that there literally should be one, that should be put out by the Board of Education. Because if you're going to put all these tablets and stuff in schoolrooms, it should be the Board of Education making the money. Not a corporation, but the Department of Education should make the money. Just like Toshiba, which is the same thing I'm recording this on right here,
mm-hmm.
went out of business, but this one right here records longer than the iTablet does.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This thing records up to 3.5 hours, where the iTablet, the ones that still come out, only records an hour.
I mean, three hours of recording difference.
Wow. Yeah. And this one right here, this is the Toshiba T100.
Mm-hmm.
This was the first one they come out with. I get 3 hours of recording off of this
still.
Thing. You know, and that's the first one they come out with.
Mm-hmm.
They still can't match that.
No.
Nothing matches that.
And right, you tried that with an iPad. First of all, you got to figure out if you can record in a, you know, I tried to record something with my phone. It's impossible.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It's had a cracked screen on it for the past year and a half.
Mm-hmm.
because it fell out, it's got a crack, two cracks on it now. I'm like, you know what? I said, I'll stick with this one. If I buy another one, I said, I'm going to buy another one. I said, they're like $50
now. I'm waving. I don't see my hand moving. I'm hiding.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're moving.
All right, guys. We're going to call it a day. We love Poughkeepsie, and I hope Poughkeepsie feels the same about us. But we're going to back out of here because we ain't going to spend no more time waiting on nobody.
I got to warm up the car.
All right, Joel. I know you're on your way. This is it for happenings around the Hudson Valley. And you're listening to WHVW 950 AM, and you have a blessed weekend, and you'll hear from us real soon. Catch us on YouTube, Happenings Around the Hudson Valley, or you can catch my Facebook and stay up to date, and that's under Stanley K. Moss. And we're out of here, and you have a blessed week, okay? And now, on with the show. This is it.
Do I have to be a registered Democrat to sign this thing for?
Joel's not in yet. Yeah, this is Stan. We just come up here. Okay, he hasn't got in yet. I just went off the air with Pat and can't help him. Okay, yeah, he should be in shortly. Alright, sir, yeah, good day. One of Joel's calling customers. He's not here, so he's not here. That's the answer to the boss about that. That's why I don't stay here.